Hey there, welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions that you have about your world and my world. Let's get started with our first question. Jeremy asks, Dear Blocko, why do we talk in our sleep? Well, obviously because you have something to say. Is this thing on? Really, talking in your sleep is an often harmless thing that can happen without a clear underlying cause. That said, sometimes talking in your sleep can be caused by certain sleep disorders, like REM sleep behavior disorder or night terrors. While different, either may cause you to yell or talk in your sleep and can lead to physically lashing out. Certain medications, stress, and fevers may also play a role. We're not really certain whether or not you're acting out your dreams or if it even has anything to do with dreaming, but we do know that it can happen during different parts of the sleep cycle. Talking in your sleep can also happen while you're sleepwalking, so to the casual onlooker, it may appear that you're conscious. I wish my body did yard work whenever I was sleeping. Those pixel bushes never stop shedding. Next question, Shachar asks, Dear Blocko, why are some people double-jointed? There are a variety of reasons that some people are double-jointed, which is kind of a misnomer, since it more so just means exceptional flexibility rather than actually having extra joints. One is that they may have shallower joints than average, which could allow for a wider range of movement. They might also have particularly soft cartilage or ligaments that are more elastic. When someone's double-jointedness has to do with their cartilage, it could be a warning sign of a severe condition like Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, or EDS. That's where collagen synthesis defects can present as extreme flexibility. What's more is that people who are double-jointed may be more likely to be anxious. Research has found correlations of sorts between the two. Some findings have even shown that patients with certain anxiety disorders can be as much as 16 times more likely to have hypermobile joints. It's extremely interesting for sure. And now it's time for questions about me and my world. Emerald Rocks Forever asks, Dear Blocko, are there any worlds in your universe that you could live on? Oh yeah, there are lots of planets. My animator is making new ones all the time. He recently just created one that's made entirely of CDs from bands of the early 2000s. Kinda random. Another one is made entirely of cheese, but the smelly kind, so honestly everyone just avoids it. Caitlin W. asks, Dear Blocko, are you ever gonna make a vlogging channel? What would you vlog? Well, I have no idea how to vlog. Is this a vlog? I don't know. I'd probably just make videos of me hanging out with my friends, or ranking video game characters, or testing out this drink I made that turns me into a mecha Blocko. I don't know, that doesn't sound interesting. Maybe someday. So do you have any questions about your world or my world? Let me know right now in the comment section below, and your question could be in a future Dear Blocko. Enjoyed this episode of Dear Blocko? Why don't you check out the previous one we did? Social anxiety disorder is a mental health condition where a person experiences a significant, persistent fear of being watched or judged by others. Subscribe and like this video if you haven't already, it really helps us out. And as always, my name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin, don't forget to keep on thinking.